Hello, LinkedIn content creators. I wanted to talk to you a little bit about making our content more inclusive, and that is really kind of preparing it so it's visually exciting, but it also works with those who need to use a web reader. And the reader we're looking at today is actually Readabout. It's one of the better ones out there. It's a Chromium app that you can download, and we're going to kind of run through that a little bit. So, you know, the first thing you kind of notice is you've got different individuals within this app, so you can have different accents, you can change speed, pitch, volume, you can do text highlighting, which is what I like to do, although those who will use this who are a little more visually challenged, they're not going to be able to do some of the highlighting, so they're probably reading the whole page, and so, you know, we want to be aware of that. So, that's Kyoto. Here's Alex. That's who I think we're going to be using. And wanted to kind of jump into that. So once we are in an area, we highlight.
Brand to land. Eliminating personal blending. Trademark. With the sharpest tools and strategies for your professional success.
So you just heard one. Now, one of the things that we talked about today, and that is using fancy fonts. Fancy fonts do not translate well. That's the kind of junk you get when you use fancy fonts, and that's what in my post, and the post was actually about why not to use fancy fonts, because they're not indexable, but they're also not functional with readers as well. So this is an example of what that first line looks like. Second line is going to be plain text, and I think once we get to the plain text, you'll get a better understanding. If we ever get there, right? This is the challenge. This is why we don't want to use fancy font if we want to be inclusive. Wow, still going. Let's give it another moment or two, and we should be into the next one. Now, personal blending, one of my taglines, that's in there, and that's actually plain text. So when it picks that up, you should hear it. Just incredible. I'm not even sure where it is in the process, because what it's saying doesn't necessarily go along with what I'm seeing. So, kind of interesting. Just a few more moments, and then we're going to get into the second line, which is plain text, and that should read fairly well. That's a lot of time. Now you know why you don't want to do this. We're almost there, I'm sure. Saw that small k.
The fact is, fancy font generators do not produce platform readable text because they are viewable graphic images like emojis.
That got that perfect. So I'm going to kind of scroll down here and actually show you. These are some of my favorite emojis to use within text. And believe it or not, readers can read emojis now. They couldn't a few years back. But this is what the kind of stuff they come up with. For all those people who use a lot of emojis, it can wear somebody out who's using a reader. So I wanted you to kind of hear that. It's going to go through them all, believe it or not. Should have had a few less.
Check mark.
So some of them make sense. Some of them are a little more technical, and so they're a little harder to understand. Actually learned what some of these are called in the process. So you can see if these are within your content, even within your profile, if you think about it, if it's that fancy font, it's not going to read well at all. If it's an emoji, it's actually going to give weird information. So I've seen emojis in people's names. This is what it's saying before your name. Doesn't really work well, right? I like the fact that they're dingbat circles. Those are pretty good. What you'll notice is the hashtags where we capitalize the right letters, as we would, called camel case for the most part. When we do that, they're easier to read visually, but they also have a great effect in the way the audio readers read them. Now, a couple of years ago, even a couple of months ago on some of the audio readers, even some of the current ones, if there's no capitalization, it will try to actually say each letter all the way through. So it'd be hashtag K-E-E-P-R, and it goes on through. With the capitalization, it can see the words going forward, and it's going to pronunciate those better. So you'll notice a difference, because this is one of the newer, better readers, and it's going to try to get them right, even when they're all small letters. So we're going to go ahead and check that out.
Number keep rocking LinkedIn. Number keep rocking LinkedIn. Number LinkedIn profile optimization. Number LinkedIn profile optimization.
So I don't know if you heard the difference in there, but there is a huge difference. And so we want to make... So there's definitely a difference in how it's pronunciated based on the fact that he can see the words ahead of time and can respond to them. So you noticed LinkedIn was the first one, and then it became LinkedIn later. So this helps both visually and on the audio side. So please make sure you're doing that. We're going to jump back here. So I'm going to jump up back into the post from yesterday. And I'm going to go ahead and highlight a couple more things, just kind of end the program, and hope you will consider those who are using these readers so that we can make our content more inclusive. And please let me know if you have any other ways to do that. I would really appreciate it. And thank you very much. Here we go.
Hope this helps everyone be more visible on, in, and number keep rocking LinkedIn. Kevin D. Turner at TNT Brand Strategist LLC.
Sounds just like me. Take care. Have a great day. Bye-bye.